What is it?
You better call the police. Yeah, come on. You better call. I'll go down.
Be careful.
Yeah.
What? 1947 Kenwood.
No, it's okay.
All right, folks, let's back it up. Let's back it up.
Be careful. Stay back.
In here!
All right, you people, stay back!
Son, it's a lot bigger than that condo in Venice, and you won't be sleeping on the living room sofa. What are you doing?
The smoke. Oh, don't. That window's off its track. It'll go down, but you can't get it back up again. Is that better?
Mother quit smoking, huh?
Yeah, she says people smoke because, well, they don't like themselves.
Ooh. Well, your mother's become quite the psychologist, I guess, huh?
You know, David, it's a good thing your school didn't let out last week. We had a lot of excitement around here. We had 3 police cars, an ambulance, a fire engine, and a TV cameraman from one of the stations.
What happened?
Wait a minute, we're almost home. I'll show you. There. See?
What happened? A fire?
No. Hank Jordan, the guy who lived there, just went crazy or something.
I imagine they'll fix it up and sell it. I just hope they do it soon. It looks so terrible the way it is.
You think your mom packed enough stuff for you?
Is something the matter?
Where you and Dad lived before didn't have all these bars in the windows.
Oh. Well, your dad put them up right after we moved in. It makes everything a lot safer. Oh, and look. Didn't want to cover up the picture window with them, so we did this. We have our own bathroom, so this one will be all yours. And this, as if you couldn't guess, is your room.
So what do you think?
Don't you like it?
It has a lot of mushrooms in it.
Would you like some soup?
Okay.
Okay. You'll have to tell me what other food you can't stand.
Okay. What's up?
What do you mean?
Well, I mean, you've been so down ever since you got here. What's wrong?
You really should have come to Colorado.
What, for the summer?
Yeah, and then we could see each other and it'd be a whole lot better. I could show you all these neat places, like there's this one place, you know, called the Roaring Fork, where you get in your inner tubes and you ride down the river and you carry a fishing pole, and I got some pictures to show you.
Sounds pretty nice, kiddo.
Yeah, and then you can stay with us at our house.
David. You know that's not possible.
I know. But then you could stay someplace else, like someplace close. And, well, she could come too, and then I could stay with you guys there.
Yeah, but I can't do that. See, I have a job. I have to stay here.
Yeah. You know, Mom doesn't have any of that stuff.
What, the microwave, you mean?
See, we used to live in an apartment in Denver. And it had all that stuff, but I don't know. We had a microwave and everything. But Mom just never used it. She was scared of it. She says it can make you sterile.
That's silly. Well, I mean, it's not true.
Well, it might have been true a long time ago, but it's just not true anymore.
Hi there.
Hey.
Hey, what are you making?
Dessert.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, we're making lemon meringue pie.
All right, fantastic. My favorite. Oh, what's this?
Oh, we rented a movie, and then David found out there's a Dodgers game tonight.
Yeah, you're still a Dodgers fan. See, I bet there's no ball team in Leadville Falls, right?
Mm-mm. Anyway, we'll eat dinner a little early, and you guys can watch it, and if there's still some time left, you can look at the tape.
Oh, tonight, see?
What about tonight?
Dan is having some people in from New York, Madison Avenue types, you know, so I told him we'd be there.
Why didn't you call?
It's not for dinner, it's for after.
What about?
Oh, no. You're invited too, son. You should come, really. Everybody would love to meet you.
Do I have to?
You'd probably rather watch the ball game. Oh.
Joe Malfitano walking over, talking to Kitty. Virgil back behind the plate. Garber stretches. And the 0-1 pitch to Mike Marshall. Base hit, left field. Marshall going for two. The throw to Auberg fell. He's in there. Yeah. Here's Chuck Tanner again, and he's motioned into his bullpen. He's going to bring in his sixth pitcher of the night, And guess who it's going to be?
Nike makes shoes for kids. Running shoes. Basketball.
Dad? At that price again, benefit when so many things for you. Just think of all the things it will do. Hi, you're on the air with Bobby.
This is Marianne.
Hi, Marianne.
Phoenix, Arizona.
Now, what can we do today, Marianne?
I'm interested in this zirconium necklace for $99.99.
Now, are you just getting one today, Marianne?
Well, gosh, I hadn't thought about getting
it. It makes a great present.
Is there a deal? Is there a deal?
Of course there's a deal. There's always a deal.
Well, how much is it?
Two would be 99 times two. Deduct $46.
Kiddo, what's going on?
The fire.
Fire?
In there.
What are you doing with the dryer?
It just came on. I was just looking at it.
Well, you shouldn't play with things like that, David. You could get hurt.
Dad, I wasn't playing with it. It just came on and it was making a noise. I was in, by the television.
What about the television?
Well, come here and look at it, and I'll show you. Come on. It was really strange. I mean, there was, like, no picture at all.
There are times when you...
Listen, David, didn't we decide on a bedtime for you tonight? I mean, it was right after the ball game.
Dad, I was in bed.
It's weird.
What is?
But, it won't turn off. With a Winston money-back
guarantee. Next time you need to stop on a dime, make sure you have my Winston brakes.
It's your main power switch. Shorted right out.
What caused it to short out?
Well, okay. Take your voltage coming in the main power station in Canoga Park. Now, the electric company will tell you that it's running smooth and steady. That's a lie. I mean, you put that thing under a magnifying scope, and that smooth, steady line starts looking like King Kong's EKG. 90-volt drop-offs, 130-volt spikes. Pulses, they're called.
So, what are you saying? Are you saying that I should call the electric company?
Well, no. See, in order to melt the switch like this, in my opinion, take a couple thousand volts at least. And if the electric company ever burped that loud, blow every damn circuit breaker in your house like that.
Then I don't understand.
Hey, join the club. You know, there's a lot of things I don't understand. Take lightning. You know, my grandpa's house
Look, there wasn't any lightning last night, was there?
You want me to admit it? Okay, I admit it. I don't have a goddamn clue what happened to your TV set. Did you get a look at the back of that thing when I had it off? I mean, you got enough chips in there to send the spaceship to Saturn. You know what I do? I read the book. I do what it says.
Hey, dude, check it out. Wow, what a skater.
Just for a while.
How come just for a while?
Because I don't live here. I'm just visiting.
Well, then where do you live?
In Colorado with my mother.
Well, then where does your dad live?
Here, that's who I'm visiting. You're not very smart, you know.
We can play there now, you know.
Where? Inside his house?
No. I wouldn't go in there for anything. And anyway, my mom let me. We can play in his yard now.
So?
We couldn't used to. He was mean. He used to yell all kind of crazy things at us.
Like what?
Like, see all that grass is dead and everything? He used to say we did that. He used to say we used to sneak around at night and put poison on it.
It's pretty crazy, all right.
My mom said he was crazy because of what happened to his wife.
What?
Man, that was bad. One day we were all around after school and we started to hear all this yelling and screaming. The police came in the ambulance and nobody knew what happened. Some of the kids said he must have murdered her.
Did he?
What's your name?
David. So what happened?
She was washing the dishes. She turned on the garbage disposal and there was something stuck in it. It was this metal thing. It wasn't even a knife or a fork. Some kind of metal thing. And when she turned it on, it shot that metal thing right up into her face. Shot it up just like a gun. Isn't that bad? It shot it up right through her eyeball.
Just listen, okay? Mom, will you please just listen? Mom. No, it's not Ellen. She's okay. Yeah, she took me riding. Yeah, the other day. No, how can I? I don't even see him, you know? He works all day, and then when he gets home, he's tired, and all he wants to do is watch television or something.
but...
Ellen!
What is it?
Ellen, look at that.
Look at what?
No, right there by the house. The grass. Is it getting enough water?
I watered it yesterday.
Oh. Yeah, well, maybe it's getting too much.
I'll check the sprinklers. Maybe they're not reaching here.
Okay, good. Yeah, look, and don't forget about the ticket, okay? Just call him as soon as he's open and then let me know. And, and tell him that I can come and pick him up on my lunch hour.
Don't worry. See you at 6.
Okay, bye-bye.
Yes. Oh, great. No, my hospital picked him up at 1:00. Is that all right?
David, you're getting wet. Come on. I'll make you some breakfast.
Okay, good. See you.
We can leave as soon as your dad gets back from work. We can have hot dogs at the ballpark. Does that sound okay?
Yeah.
Well, you don't sound very enthusiastic.
What happened to his grass?
Huh?
Well, you know the man across the street? He said the kids were putting poison on it, didn't he?
Well, he said a lot of things after his wife died. Paranoid, you know? I guess he just stopped taking care of things and began to blame everyone else.
So it started to die after his wife got killed?
Yeah. Well, no, actually, it was before, but it got a lot worse afterwards. Why the sudden interest in poor Mr. Jordan's grass?
I don't know.
You look like you've seen a ghost.
Stevie, come on. No, I don't want to.
Stevie, come on. Don't be such a wimp.
No, my mother told me not to. It's dangerous.
Come on, Stevie. She's not gonna even know.
No, I don't want to.
Stevie, if you don't come on right now, I'm not gonna play with you ever again. Come on.
What are you doing here? Spooky, ain't it? Did it talk to you? The voice in the wires. See? Yeah. Fried him like an onion. Why do you figure he did it? Smashed the place up, I mean.
I don't know. Alan just said he went, like, crazy one night.
Crazy? That's exactly what those son of a bitches would say. They probably had that poor bastard thinking he was going crazy. I know all about it. I must have seen 20 houses just like this one. And after the first few, I started having me a real close look. And I know what I know, boy. But I'm not telling it. Not anymore.
No, sir. Let them call these other poor devils crazy if they want to, but not me.
All right, sports fans, let's go.
Great. Great seats, love.
Look at this. First baseline.
I think maybe you should sit down. We seem to have a problem.
Well, it's a long drive, you know? We don't want to be late. Okay. What is it?
David went over to the Jordan house this afternoon.
Ah. That wasn't very smart, David. I mean, it's dangerous there. You could get hurt.
I know, but listen, please.
He seems to think that what happened at the Jordan house is going to happen here.
It comes in through the wires. I saw it. And that night that you were gone, I felt it.
Wait a minute. Come on now. Let's slow down. You felt what?
The voice in the wires. He's met some crazy old man in the Jordan house, and...
He's not crazy, and Mr. Jordan wasn't crazy, and the thing that killed him is in here now, and I just don't want to stay here anymore. And I just want to get out of this house right now!
Yeah, look.
Bill, why don't we...
Why don't you go upstairs for a little while and let me and Ellen talk about this, okay?
No!
Yeah, look, please, just for a little while, okay?
What do you think you're doing? Hey. Come on. What?
No, Dad.
What?
I don't want to stay in the house. Yes. Dad. Okay. No, Dad. No. Please. Hey. No! Dad! Don't make me go in there! Hey. No, Dad. I don't want to go in there! No! No, Dad! No! Hey. Dad! No! No, don't
let me
go!
Come on,
Dad. Let's just go. Dad, you heard me. Stop it. Dad, you heard me.
Did you talk to him? The old guy?
Well, after David calmed down, I went over to talk to him, but he wasn't there. His truck was gone. I don't know. Do you think something could be wrong with the electricity? It's just that David seems so scared.
Yeah, well, I mean, of course he's scared. It was that night we left him alone. See, that was the beginning of it. And then today, gee, I mean, he goes into that house and some crazy bastard jumps down at him out of the ceiling. I mean, that would have scared me to death. Aren't you supposed to take this back?
Oh, I did. They called this morning. There was something wrong with the tape. It must have happened when the TV set broke. I had to buy it. It cost $60.
It's just that if he leaves in this state, he's never going to want to come back here again. And how can I be his father if I never see him? I mean, you understand? I love him.
He's going to be okay. Let's get some sleep. We'll work it out.
I hope it was a lousy game.
David, I'm sorry I have to go to this meeting. You sure you don't want to come over with me to the campus? You could walk around. You're gonna be all right?
Yeah.
You sure? Mm-hmm.
Attacking the terror dome. Want to play? Come on, you can be the Cobras.
No, not really.
Okay, you can be the G.I. Joes.
No. How do you get to the airport?
Why do you want to go to the airport?
Is there a bus or something?
No, I don't think so. It's a long way away. Are you going back to Colorado?
Yeah, I had the ticket. I just got to get the time changed.
Steven, get in here right now.
Okay. Maybe my mom will drive you. Do you want me to ask her?
No, it's okay. Thanks, Steve.
Steven, right now.
Okay. So what are you gonna do?
Thank you.
This is crucial. The first person to buzz in with the correct answer wins the money in the puzzle bank, and in this case, will win the game. So be very careful. Hands on your buzzers. You may buzz in as soon as the next letter is revealed, but not before, or you'll be disqualified. Ready? Go. H. Will.
They lived happily ever after.
And you will, yes. They lived happily ever after.
Was a lot more scared than hurt. The bruises from the collision and mild shock is what the doctor said. The gas didn't really hurt him, but if he'd been there any longer...
Oh, Jesus.
Mr. Rockland? Can I show you something?
Yeah, sure.
I slugged your line with a new piece of pipe, so now I'm going to turn the main back on, relight all your pilots. Right here's your problem. Split wide open. Actually, you're pretty lucky.
Lucky?
Oh, yeah. Volume of gas you had in here and the ignition of that station wagon turned on. This whole place could have blown sky high.
Look, I mean, what could have caused this pipe to split like this?
Metal fatigue. See that window right there?
Afternoon sun comes blazing through there right on that spot. Pipe heats up. Sun moves on, it cools back down. Expansion, contraction, just wears the metal out till one day. Anyway, that new pipe ought to last you another 10, 20 years. You might think about getting some sheetrock on this wall. It'll help insulate it.
Yeah, I will.
Okay, well, I'll get that main right on.
Thank you very much.
And then everything will be just fine again, won't it?
Ma'am?
Oh, something happens and it almost kills someone, and you people come here and you talk about pulses and metal fatigue, and you pull out some pipe or switch and you say, here you are, just slapping a new one of these, and you don't know what's happening. I mean, you don't know what's really happening here,
hey,
do you?
Hey,
do you?
Come on. Calm down now.
Bill,
please.
Why is it doing this to us? What does it want? Last night I couldn't sleep. I just lay in bed listening. You know all the little sounds there are at night. The furnace turning on and off, the refrigerator, and I heard something else. Something growing inside the house, getting stronger.
The voice in the wires?
And what do you call all this, an accident?
Yeah. Yes, that's exactly what I call it, an accident. I mean, what do you want me to call it? What do you want me to believe, that there's some thing in the house that is trying to kill my son? Come on, I mean, that is crazy.
Yes, that's what we called him, poor Mr. Jordan. We said he was crazy. Was he?
Okay. Listen to me now. Listen, what happened today was this. Right here. Look at it. You see? This is what happened. It's not a monster. It's not a plot. It's not a plan. It's not a conspiracy. It just is what it is. It's a stupid hunk of metal.
And how many more things like this are there? How many more things that we don't even know about until someday one of them breaks and almost kills one of us?
God damn it! Stop it! I mean, what is this about? Do you want to leave too? Is that it? I mean, just, I don't know what's happening. Do you want to leave too?
Oh, God.
You're gonna be late for your meeting. I could have done that.
Yeah. Okay. So if anything should happen, anything, just call me, and I'll come right home.
Okay. I promise.
I'll be over at the place on Thornton. There's no phone there. So if you run into a hitch, just work around it.
Don't leave. I want you to tell me about the houses.
Tell you what, lady?
You know what? You told my son. I want you to tell me.
Lady, I didn't tell nobody around here nothing. And I'll be glad to tell you the same thing.
Okay. Okay. Turn off the faucets. And I'll tell you what to do.
Do?
Yes, do. Or would you rather hide in your hole and hope for the best? Pull the plug, lady. Pull all the plugs. Disconnect yourself. Fast. And not just up there at the top of the pole. That don't mean nothing. It don't just crawl in on your wires. It ain't a thing. It's a signal. Pulse. Kinda like a voice. So what you've got to do is to get rid of anything in your house that might have ears to hear it. Me, I'm back to wood fires and kerosene lamps. My wife would like to kill me. But she thought I was nuts when I built the fallout shelter. But you wait and see. I was right about that one, too. I heard a man on TV one time say that paranoia is just another word for heightened awareness. But you do what you want to, lady. What the hell do I know? I'm crazy.
Wait!
The hardware store in the mall's got a special on kerosene. It smells some, but it sure does make a pretty light.
You up there?
Dad!
Hi.
What?
Oh.
I talked to your mother. She's coming on Sunday.
Take me back?
Well, see, I was hoping that we could just sit down and maybe talk things over and...
Bill, if you need anything, Ruby and I'll be upstairs. We'll get some fresh linen and things for the guest room.
Okay, thanks. Ellen's okay. Well, I mean, I know it looked pretty bad and everything, but they said that she would just have to stay there in the hospital for a while. And without Ellen here, your mom is coming here tomorrow morning, and we're gonna pack you up and you can go with her home. Look, so Howard just said just now that you could stay here tonight if you wanted to, and it would be okay with me. I mean, if it would make you feel better.
Can you stay here too?
Sure. If you want me to.
David?
Thank you. Go on. Where are the keys?
No.
The axe.
Dad!
Drop it. I said drop it. Now!
Your house that you just wrecked, wasn't it?
Yes, it was, yes.
You must both be crazy.
Yes, we are. We're both of us. We are, aren't we? We're crazy.
Yeah.
Oh, God, are we crazy?
Yeah.